Hi, hello, good morning. Welcome to today's session. So in the previous session we were discussing about the concept, what is Indian secular system, from the chapter Understanding Secularism. To the concept, we were discussing, or we discussed different points to state how the secularism is mainly given importance in India. So first point, Indian constitution itself is mandates that Indian state to be secular. Then one religion should not dominate on another in a secular state, and the members of one particular religion should not dominate on other members belonging to other particular religion in the community, and state should not force any particular religion, nor it should not take away religious freedom of individuals, and schools, colleges should not promote any one particular religion through education to the masses. And in order to respect the sentiments of religious feelings, state should not interference in the religious practices, and because of that certain exceptions were given to particular religious communities. After discussing about these many points, let us continue what makes Indian secularism. About this, let us continue remaining points which we left to discuss in previous session. Point number 8. In order to prevent religious dominance, religion based exclusion and discrimination of lower castes, in Indian constitution it clearly banned untouchability. So in order to create equality, in order to create unity, fraternity among all the people, constitution itself has taken serious measures to prevent, control religious based practices. Moreover, religious based discrimination of the people on the grounds of caste, creed, color and others. That's why practice of untouchability, it is banned. Then to prevent, to control, to eradicate social evils, social practices, states may have to intervene in the religion based orders. Means people living in society will be having their own customs, traditions, cultures, practices and so on. But religious based social practices should not harm the dignity and self-respect of other people living in the society. That's why state need to take intervene in religion based orders. So in the case of US, United States, there the constitution of US got first amendment. So the first amendment of US constitution explains clearly that legislature prohibits making laws with due respect or respecting an establishment of religion. It means the legislature cannot declare any religion as official religion. In the US, all the religions are equally respected, equally treated, and equally given importance. There is no any such favor given for any such particular religion. So, separation between state and religion means neither state nor religion can interfere in the affairs of each other. So that is what separation. So either religion or either state, both should not interfere in the matters of their own. Indian state is described, stated as secular because it works in various ways to prevent religion dominance, religious dominance. Like US, like India, the state can interfere in religion on the ideal laid down in the constitution. Ideal means moral values. For example, if casteism is given importance to practice, then on the grounds of caste, the people belonging to higher caste, always they go on expressing their dominance on the people belonging to lower class. So this kind of dominance may create inequality among the people. So in these kind of situations, India, Indian Constitution, USA, they are given provision to interfere in these kind of matters. That's why in India, untouchability is banned by the law. So with this, let us end today's session and let us continue our discussion further in tomorrow's session. Until then, take care of yourself. Stay at home, stay safe. Thank you. Thank you.